the turn of a single card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you, Charlie O'Donnell. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Shark. We're going to start our day off with a tiebreaker to find out who our champion's going to be. But before we meet our card sharks, let's meet our two dealers. Here they come right now. They are the two prettiest ladies in television, Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Here they are.
Oh, good
morning, ladies. Yay! Very nice indeed. We have a new rule with a tiebreaker. So we'll tell the folks about it after you deal out the cards and we meet our card sharks. Come on, Debbie and Jim. Here we go.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Deb. Debbie, our champion, has won $4,300 so far. And tell us a little bit about Debbie real quick, then.
Well, I was a glow wrestler.
Yep.
And I'm not doing that anymore because it hurts.
It hurts, yes. So you're going to have children instead.
No.
Oh, no.
None of those yet. They hurt, okay. Too. But I don't know, but I've heard. But anyways.
And you're the champion.
Yeah.
And you're going to play the tiebreaker.
That's
here.
Right.
Okay. Jim, how about you?
My name's Jim Wolf. I'm from Garden Grove, California. I'm a police sergeant for the city of Vernon, currently assigned to patrol division. Married, three kids, and some of my hobbies include collecting baseball memorabilia.
All right. Here's our first question, and Debbie, the question goes to you, and this question involves our 10 teenagers who are all going steady. They've been with us all week, and there they are. Now, remember, this is tiebreaker. Let's find out who our champion is going to be. Debbie, before the show, we ask our 10 teenagers, do your parents think you're too young to go steady? How many of these 10 teenagers said their parents do think that they're too young to go steady?
Well, yeah, they look pretty young to me, and I think their parents probably do think they're too young to go steady. So I'm going to say about four of them.
Four of them. All right, let's see what Jim says. Jim?
Well, knowing parents now in the 80s, they're not too young to go steady. It's gonna be a little bit less than that.
Think it might be less than that? Oh, I don't know. That's the audience is going mumble, mumble, mumble. The actual number of these teenagers whose parents think that they're too young to go steady is two of them. You're right, Jim. I'm surprised at that. I'm really surprised. I really am. Which two of you guys' parents think you're too young to go steady? Oh, Nathan. Poor old Nathan. His parents think everything about you, don't they, Nathan? Jason, do they really? Why do they think that, Jason?
Well, I'm still 15, and I don't have my driver's license yet, so they have to pick me up and take me back.
They think you're too young to date them, don't they? Much less go steady. All right, fellas, thank you very much. Nice to have you with us. Okay, now, this is tiebreaker time. Jim's got the control. The new rule on tiebreaker basically is we're going to turn over the two base cards, and at that point, Jim, you can make the decision as to whether you want to play or pass to find out who our champion is going to be. So, Susanna, if you would, please turn over Jim's base card.
Okay.
Turn over Debbie's base card.
Okay.
Now, Jim, you want to play or you want to pass?
Well, I'm going to put it in my own hands. Lower!
He's going on. All right. Is it lower than the king? It is.
Oh.
Now, he has the option to play or freeze. What's he going to do? No, he doesn't. They don't have that option. No, sorry about that. You got to play. It's sudden death.
Higher, Bob.
All right. If it's higher, you are the new champ. If not, Debbie's the champ. Is it higher than the seven? No, it's not. And Debbie wins the championship.
What an amazing. Thank you.
Hey, Jim, you end up with $100. We have some nice gifts for you. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, Bobby.
Okay, good luck with the new baby, too. Come here, Lucky. All right. Oh, are you something? Yeah. Okay, Debbie is our champion again. That means she's going to go back and play the big money cards. Last time she did pretty well. She won over $4,000. We'll see how she does today, right after this. Here you go, baby.
Funny on TV is nearly extinct. A good comic is a...
Welcome back to Card Shark. Okay, Debbie. That was a good game. That was close, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Now, you know what's about to happen. You have a chance to win up to $32,000 over here. And in addition to all that money you can win, we've added a couple of jokers to the deck. When a joker comes up, that gives you a chance of winning a brand new car. And because you're the champion, you won two games. Susanna's got a joker for you, so you know you at least have one opportunity of winning that car. Give the lady $200. That's what she's going to need to bet with, and we're on our way. All right. Here we go, Deb. Your first card happens to be a queen.
Okay, I'm going to go $200, right?
$200, yes.
I'm going to go all of it lower.
All of it lower than the queen. How about an eight for you? $400. Player change.
Change that card.
Which one?
Number three.
Number three. Let's see what the eight becomes now. Lacey's got a new card for you, and that card is an ace. Yeah, all of it lower than the ace. There's a four. You got $800.
$800. $700 higher.
$700 higher than the four. Look at that. 15. I'll give you another $400. You've got $1,900.
All of it lower.
All of it lower than the ace. Yes, it is. $3,800. Player change the nine.
Change that card.
Change that card.
Number two.
Okay, Lacey now has a new card for you, and that nine is now a four again with $3,800.
$3,000 higher.
$3,000. Oh, $3,000 higher than the four. There you go. $6,800, Debbie. Now be careful.
I'm going to say.
Be careful now. What do you think, Deb? $6,800.
$1,000 lower.
$1,000 lower than the 10. Is it lower than the 10? It is. $7,800 to 5. You can play or change the 5. Up to you.
I have to bet half, right?
You have to bet at least half of them. You can change the 5 or you can play the 5. You've got $7,800. You've got to bet.
Change it.
Want to change it? All right. Let's see what the 5 now becomes a 3. Now you got to bet at least $3,900. You got $7,800.
I have how much?
$7,800.
$7,000 higher.
$7,000 higher. Is it higher? Yeah! $14,800. Added to the money you had earlier, you've now got $19,200. Okay, come here. What'd you say?
Praise the Lord.
Oh, praise the Lord, yes.
There you go.
Here we go. You ready? We're not done. The excitement is just beginning, my dear. You now have in front of you 7 numbered cards. Behind one of them is the word car. You find it, and this is the car you'll win. Charles?
It's the Mercury 2-door Tracer, the small car equipped with more than 68 standard features, including a 5-speed transmission, comes with California emissions.
All right, what are you shaking for?
Because I'm happy.
Well, I guess you ought to be happy. You got $19,000.
I know.
Yeah, go win a car. Okay, you got that girl, that's a way.
Oh.
Well, is it upside down?
I thought it might be.
Oh, yeah, no, I don't think it is. I think it's okay now. All right. Come on, Debbie, somebody says. We're rooting for you, sweetie. We want you to win that car. Is it behind number 3? It was behind number 5.
Oh.
Right there was the car. But, heck, you got $19,200. We'll pause and we'll come back to meet a new challenger for our champion right after this. That'll make your referee happy.
This could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Okay, Debbie, time to meet a new challenger. And here he is right now. Hello, Steve.
Hello.
How are you, Steve?
I'm fine, thank you.
Have you met Debbie?
Yes, I have.
Got a heck of a handshake.
She does.
Yeah.
My name is Steve Joachim. I'm originally from Green Bay, Wisconsin, home of the Green Bay Packers. I now live in Lancaster, California, home of the San Andreas Fault.
Son, what have you done wrong?
I don't know.
Well, you don't
play
this
map.
Game, huh? Okay, well, it's nice to have you with us anyway. Lancaster's a nice town. I like it up
beautiful.
There.
Beautiful, yes.
Green Bay. It's cold there, isn't it?
Yes. I'd say the desert for the tundra. Though.
How's your football team? Never mind. Here we go. Got them dealt out, Susanna? Let's play. Okay, Debbie, first question is yours. Game number one. Surveyed 100 married women, just like you. We asked them, are you secretly thinking about divorcing your husband? How many married women admitted they are?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
No, I don't believe that. I'm not thinking of divorcing my husband. I have a great husband. And,
and after you won 19 grand, he's not thinking about it either, honey.
But I'm going to say that's not very high. I'm going to say about 20.
20. Not very high at 20, okay. Steve, higher or lower than 20?
I definitely believe it's going to be a lower number.
I think
absolutely.
It might be lower.
Absolutely.
Well, let's see. The actual number of married women who are secretly thinking about divorcing their husband is... 10 of them. Yes, it was lower. All right. Steve, welcome to our show. You know you can change this card Let's see if you want to. No.
No, lower.
Lower than the king. Jack is your card.
Lower.
Go on. How about an 8?
Freeze.
Freeze on the 08. Sure. Strategy there is to keep W away from the cards and let's see if it works. Okay. Steve, here's a... This is an educated guess question for Steve.
Okay.
Oh, Debbie loves these. What do you do for a living, Steve?
I'm a manager for a theme park here in California.
Oh, all right. What is the average cost for a heart transplant at Stanford University Medical Center?
Wow. The medical expenses are certainly going up. I would say the cost for a heart transplant would be around
$250,000. $250,000. Let's see what Debbie says. Higher or lower than $250,000, Deb?
I'm going to say it's a little bit lower than
I think it might be a little bit lower. Let's find out. The average cost for a heart transplant at Stanford University Medical Center is $90,000. A heck of a lot lower, isn't it? Yeah. Woo. Wow. Okay, Debbie, you ready?
Yeah.
Here we go. There's a card for you, Jack.
Lower.
Gonna go lower than the Jack, is it?
Yeah. Higher.
Higher. Here we go.
Higher.
Going on. Higher than the 6.
Yeah. Freeze.
Freeze in the old 10. Okay. Freeze right there. One card away from winning game number 1. Next question goes to Debbie. Debbie, have you ever been to a psychiatrist, huh?
Yes.
Yeah. I just want to know if you know anything about this question. You see, everything all right?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Fine. Yeah.
Everything's fine.
This before or after you started wrestling, did you go to the psychiatrist?
This is after.
After, yeah. Let's see why. We surveyed 100 psychiatrists. We asked them, generally speaking, can a woman who works outside the home raise a child as well as a mother who stays at home all the time? How many psychiatrists said, yeah, a woman who works can raise a child just as well as a mother who stays home?
I don't know. It's tough these days when the woman's got to juggle both of those things, you know, the home, the kids, and the job and stuff. So I don't think a lot of psychiatrists are going to agree with that because they can't spend enough time with the kids. So I'm going to say it's going to be about 30.
30 out of 100 say a woman can raise a child just as well as a mother who stays at home. A woman who works can. Okay, Steve?
I really think that a woman who stays at home has more time to spend with their child, can be creative with them, can work with them on their schoolwork, and I really believe that they would do a better job raising a child. So I think that the number is definitely going to be lower.
Okay, is that right? Okay, that's right. Okay, the actual number of psychiatrists who said a woman who works can raise a child as well as a mother who stays home is 64 of them. No, was it lower? It was higher, and it's Debbie.
Change
it, Tim.
Yeah.
Gotcha. 10 becomes a 6, Deb. If it's higher, you win the game, do you? Yes, you do. Well, all right. Game number 1 is yours, Debbie. Steve, you got to win this next game.
Yeah.
We will deal out the cards, and we'll start game number 2. But first, we must do some business. We'll be right back. We'll be right after this.
Check it out, Chub W, coming at you tried and true, sleeky freak.
New Dulcolax Stool Softener. Make yourself comfortable.
Welcome back to Card Shark. We're ready to start game number 2. Steve, the first question goes to you. Cards have been dealt out from the same deck, and we're on our way. And this question involves our 10 teenage boys who are going steady. Been with us all week, and they're ready to play the game again. Okay, now before the show, we asked these 10 teenagers, have you ever asked for a lock of your girlfriend's hair? Yeah, how many of these 10 teenagers have asked their girlfriend for a lock of their hair?
Well, while it's a very romantic notion, I don't think that many people actually do it today. I think that their interests may lie elsewhere. I think it's going to be a very low number. I'd say out of the 10, 2.
Why are you laughing, Debbie?
Nothing. I think that's going to be even lower than that.
Even lower than that?
Yeah, I don't think they asked for
it. No one's ever asked for a lock of your hair?
No.
No? The actual number of these teenagers who have asked their girlfriend for a lock of her hair is none of them. 0. Justin, I can't imagine. Do you have a good-looking girlfriend, Justin?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, and she has pretty hair?
Yeah, I don't usually ask girls for a lock of their hair. They usually ask me.
I should have known that. You know, it happens to me all the time, Justin. I just take a couple of them off the sink and give it to him. Yeah. Thank you, fellas. Okay. Here we go, Debbie. You ready?
Okay, ready.
There is a 10. Want to play a 10?
Change the card.
Change the card. All right. Zen's got a new one. Now I got a queen.
Lower.
Lower than the queen. 10 again.
Lower.
going on? Is it lower? No. No. Okay, Steve, you didn't win the question, so you can't change it, but let's see what you got. Tens of plenty.
Lower. Say,
huh? Okay, lower than the 10. Yeah, all right.
Lower.
Going on, man said. Nope. Back to the base card you go. So, Debbie has a queen, Steve has a 10, and I've got another question for you, Debbie.
Okay.
Business executives who are married men is what this one is about.
Okay.
And we ask these 100 business executives who are married men, does your wife complain that you spend too much time at the office? Mm-hmm. How many business executives said their wife does complain they spend too much time at the office?
Well, we have some friends that are business executives.
Are they in jail?
I know these. No.
No.
No. And they spend a lot of time at the office, so,
yeah.
And their wives get mad at them. So I'm going to say that's a pretty high number. I'm going to say about 60.
Go ahead and say it there.
60.
Thank you. Steve, higher or lower than 60?
I work with a big company. I know a lot of executives, and they do put in a lot of hours. However, 60 seems like a high number. I think it's going to be lower.
It's going to be lower than that. Actual number of the business executives whose wife complains they spend too much time at the office is 60 of them. Right on the old button. Boy, when you say you know business executives, you know business executives. One, two, three, four, five $100 bills. That's yours. Okay. And the rich get richer.
That's right.
Lower.
Going to go lower than this queen. Here we go.
Higher.
All right, higher. Yep.
Well, freeze.
Freeze in a step. Debbie wants to freeze so she can put her money away. I know what she's doing. Okay. All right, Steve, next question is yours. Now, we surveyed 100 actors and actresses who appear in daytime soap operas. We asked them, do you ever get bored playing the same character day after day? How many soap opera stars said, yeah, they do get bored sometimes?
Well, a lot of actors who have been on soap operas have been on there for 10, 15, 20 years. And I can imagine that they do get tired playing the same role. Out of 100,
yeah.
I would say 45 of them are really tired of playing
45 out of 100, all right. Let's see what Debbie, you better put the money away. It's just what are you going to do with that money?
Now, I don't
careful.
Have a pocket.
Yeah. Okay, just hang on to it then, okay? Yeah, good.
Okay. I'm going to say, let's see this. These are, they're
it says 45 out of 100 soap opera stars get bored.
Oh. Yeah, I think they get tired because we used to, like, do, like, skits and stuff and the wrestling and stuff.
You do
on the
skits?
Set. Yeah, you know, like jokes and you know, silly things, you know, promos and...
Oh, promos and things. That's your business stuff, yeah.
Yeah, okay. And you're on the set long hours and stuff, and it gets
higher or lower than 45 here?
I'm going to say it's going to be higher.
Higher? The actual number of soap opera stars who get bored playing the same character is 47 of them. Woo! You almost won $500, Steve.
Yeah.
Debbie, you want to change the 7, I assume?
Change
the,
yeah.
We will. 7 becomes a 4.
Higher!
Higher than a 4-5.
Higher!
If it's higher, you win game number 1.
Oh!
Steve is applauding. All right, Steve with the 10. Let's see what you can do with it.
Lower.
Lower than the 10. No. Oh, didn't make it. Okay. We must pause for these words, but when we come back, we're going to play. What are we going to play, Debbie?
Sudden Death.
Sudden Death. Yeah, we'll be right back for that in just a moment.
Really?
Oh.
Ooh, Old Queen, the ketchup is
just hand comfort. It's a beautiful thing.
Go Tagless.
That's all the time we have for today. That means that we're going to have to play Sudden Death next time. Yeah, that's going to excite the heck out of you. Yeah, I know it would. We hope you'll be back with us. We have such a good time today, and thank you very much for joining us. For Susanna Williams, Lacey Pemberton, Charlie O'Donnell's with us this week. Charlie, nice to have you with us. I'm Bob Eubanks saying so long, everybody, from Card Sharks. Please join us. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
This is a Lifesavers Fusions. It has
game.
Need to lose those extra pounds? Let Cram and Game Show Network show you how. Tighten those muscles as you walk on hamster wheels. Sweat away those love handles playing hockey with cheese. Pedal bikes as your partner answers ridiculous riddles.
What is purple and 5,000 miles long?
And melt those inches off your waist. But wait, there's more. There's also 24-hour sleep deprivation and the trainer from hell, Graham Elwood.
Get back on your hamster wheel.
Get up, come on!
Cram tonight at 11 p.m. Eastern and Pacific on Game Show Network.